said, he said, don't talk to me, don't talk to me, don't talk to me. I want to know some bad blood.
Yeah, that's what I want to know about.
I think that's where it all feels right.
Yeah, I want to know where it came from. I know in the beginning, you know, Dickinson was upset, you know, at Maryland because they didn't win. He started it, maybe.
Michigan, if you care about the announcers on
Saturday night. Andrew Cotter, 940.
Playing all those West Coast teams.
Yeah.
A quick fat check on the 2011 BC Rams.
Yes.
They played University of Southern California.
Oh, USC. I was
playing in 2011.
USC, UCLA. It's like, you know, mixing up the situations. Anyway, So Michigan State is a 11 seed. And look, there was a lot. When you were watching the bracket, you're sitting there saying, they're going to get in here. You know, we always assumed, you know, because they were late. And there was one that's, I was watching it with my wife while we're eating, and they the audio on loud. I think Norfolk State might be the Spartans as well. So three Spartans in there, because I don't think San Jose State. So, look, they're playing a playing game. They know what kind of season they had. In a normal year, you know, with other teams not playing well either, they might not have even made it with their record. But, you know, to their credit, they played all their games, and they dealt with COVID to their team, to their players. And the reason they're in the tournament is very simple in my mind, and I'm sure everybody else's, because they were able to beat Ohio State, Illinois, and Michigan in an eight-day span. You know, when you beat, you know, two number one seeds and a number two seed, you get in. And that's why they're in the tournament. Tom Izzo was asked, I believe by me, Zoom press conference, about the play-in.
I'm not going to be upset about a play-in game. I think our conference and league office should be, because I think it doesn't serve what this conference did this year.
So he went through most of the press conference, because, you know, look, as much as I love Tommy, he knows, he whines, he makes little, this is not an excuse, but, he understood where they were seated. He thought some of the other teams in the conference could have had better seeds, and look, he's probably miffed, but to a certain extent, that they are in a playing game when you see some of the other teams. You know, why are they in a playing game and Syracuse isn't? Syracuse has, like, hardly any, couldn't beat anybody, really. So I get that.
Until they beat Illinois, not many people thought that right. They were going to have this chance. And then they beat Ohio State.
Exactly.
They beat Michigan to round out the season. That's where they earned the right to get to the tournament. And whether they play a playing game or whether they're still in the tournament.
Yes.
I mean, I'm sure Spartan fans are feeling a little bit upset that they have to, of the indignity of playing the play-in game.
No, the indignity of watching it starting at 9:40. 9:47.
Whatever. It doesn't matter.
Yeah.
It's going to be a late one, but they're in the tournament.
Yeah, and they actually got a decent draw, if you think about it. If they win that game, I mean, if they win that the play-in game, I mean, they're going to play Brigham Young, who... Anybody can beat anybody, but they're really not that good.
Right.
You know, it's not a great team. And then, you know, they win that game, they probably play Texas. It was pretty good.
Yeah.
Texas is good. And they're in this. Then they're in the same deal with, you know, Maryland, Alabama, Connecticut, and that squad.
Alabama,
so, yeah. You know, Michigan, on the other hand, as a one seed, you know, they got LSU probably in round two, and that's not going to be easy. And then Florida State in round three, or maybe Colorado's better than we think. I don't know. So, look, obviously Michigan got the worst of the one seeds, which was deserved. They should have been the fourth seed in the tournament.
Absolutely. So would this be Izzo's ultimate, like, one-up if he got out of that region and all the way to the Final Four and Michigan did?
Yeah.
Or if they played a regional final, like that would be like the cherry on top. But finally, right, with everything's done on the last year for us locally,
that'd be great.
The odds of it are extremely low.
Right. I know. Just get a team. They face
each other in the Elite Eight.
I told you guys, I like UConn, man.
Yeah, they're playing great. They're good. Well, they, you know, I can't believe they lost to Georgetown. Georgetown's been, and they lost to Creighton. Georgetown got on a run. See, that's the other thing. You know, there are a few teams that got in the tournament that the only reason they got in was because they won the championship.
Right.
Conference. Even in the big show. Like, Georgetown had no better reason to be in the tournament. They took a spot on that. Don't forget, you have these four teams that are on COVID alert, too.
Dude, that's great. Right. That was so weird watching that.
I know. Everybody seems to think the one team that got jobbed is Belmont, because they won, like, 24 games or something. that. So anyway, here's some ticket takes. I'm worried about Michigan not being at full strength. Izzo needs to stop complaining about everything. They have a losing conference record with a lot of double-digit losses. That's Mike and Williamson. Yeah, I mean, when you lose the Rutgers by 30 grand in first game Kindloff, their pause with their players actually had COVID. Michigan's pause was different. None of their players had COVID. So you're going to compare pauses. Michigan State's was worse. Yeah, Izzo complains about a lot of stuff. But I watched the whole press conference. He wasn't in full. Top shelf Izzo complaint. He just feel a little wonder. When and why did they change the days of the playing games? Tournament used to start on Tuesday. Playing games used to be Tuesday, Wednesday. Now tournament starts on Saturday.
Well, that's just this year.
It's all for COVID. The travel deals and that.
It's the testing. They have to have 7 days of negative tests before you can enter the thing or whatever.
Friday is round one. Which, yes. By the way, Jamie always said Friday's the underrated day in the tournament because it's the same as Thursday, but you get Friday too.
That's true. So now Saturday is as good as Friday.
Right. Are all their arenas going to look the same and all that stuff, the courts?
Yes, they're new courts. Yes.
I've seen...
They're playing at Purdue.
Yeah, I've seen, like, the pictures of, like, Hinkle Fieldhouse with the logo, March Madness in the middle. Mm-hmm. Classic Walmart Wolverine saying he got kicked out of the game to light a fire. Not done with a purpose. Done because he's a moron.
I'm a Walmart Wolverine?
Yeah.
Okay.
He's not a Walmart. He's the actual opposite of a Walmart Wolverine. He went there and he played there.
I'm a Walmart Wolverine, and I'm the one that didn't like it.
Yeah.
I thought it looked minor league. Yeah. I think he's, I like Juwan Howard a lot. He's done great things. He stepped into this, but he's ultimately going to be judged on what Beeline excelled at, which is NCAA tournament performance. And this year, he will get a little bit of a free pass because of the liver's injury. And just the situation in general, the unknown.
That's his first one.
Right. Well, I don't know if I... That's the least of the excuses for him.
Well, I agree, but there is a learning curve. And there is... I think there's got to be a learning curve in the Big Ten tournament as well. And the fact of the matter is, too, they lost. And did it really affect them?
I know, but here's the thing. I think he feels... I think he's got a little big boy britches on sometimes. You know, we've tried to get him on this show. And we always get the alternative, Phil Martelli, and he doesn't have time for us, not once.
I don't know.
I came on this show numerous times, and I know it. Maybe I'm being selfish here a little bit, but there's a little bit of responsibilities that the former coach lived up to that Juwan doesn't. And it's not only just our show. It's other media obligations and other things. And then you see him fly off the handle like that. It's like... I just don't see what provoked that kind of reaction.
My complaint with the last play was they waited too long and didn't give themselves a second chance because of it.
Yep.
They got the switch they wanted, they just didn't take advantage of it. Exactly. I mean, and he looked confused, too, Smith and Jordan. Michigan peaked too early, they looked tired. They paired it up with Howard, more interested in fighting coaches. They're drawing up a coherent last play. They'll be lucky to make it out of the first week. That's your team plans. My biggest criticism of Juwan Howard was when he would leave his starters in when they were up 15 to 20 points very late in games. This is potentially when liver's injury could have happened. Brian and Ben Harper. Well, we don't know if that's the case. But yes, I agree. But he's not alone. Injuries happen, but coaches have this ridiculous notion of paranoia that they think with a 25-point lead with 4 minutes left, I should still be leaving my players, my starters in the game. It's ridiculous. It is. Because you know what else it doesn't do? It doesn't give some of your other players who practice their asses off a chance to play.
Oh, they need a gold star too?
It's not to do with a gold star. Why would you? Well, we should have this complete discussion coming up later in the show. It's like, you know what? You should have gone to Clarkson instead of Clawson. Because Dan Fife would play, he'd be up by 30 and he'd only play six guys. That's ridiculous. All right. Heather has news.
Yes. Well, there could be a celebrity sighting or maybe a celebrity run-in in Ann Arbor. So I'll tell you which celebrity...